Hey Fubar, wanted to give you this video response to your rolling your own. Good idea, a good way to save money. Thought I might be able to give you some tips. I've been doing this for a couple years now, and I save a ton of money by doing it. And I think I have a superior cigarette. So, first thing, I know I have a different machine here, but they all basically work the same. I use the Premier. Mine has like the tube selector here for the size of the tube you're using. One tip I might want to give you is on the tubes, when you slide these on, if you put the seam of the tube in between this brass piece and the rubber, that'll prevent some tear out. And sometimes that can be a problem if you're overpacking. Boy, this is blurry. And another thing, the kind of tubes I use, I use these Laramie shorts. I like a short cigarette. They're full flavor. I like to taste them. I usually, if I'm smoking a king, I usually throw away more than I smoke. So I put them out, I snuff them out too, but the short ones work better, so you could tell the difference between a king and the shorts. There's quite a bit of difference, and it just makes your tobacco go farther. And one other thing, when you're actuating your lever, I know a lot of people have a tendency to push down on this arm, and that'll tend to break this mechanism in here. And I imagine even with your brand machine, it might happen. So always make sure you're coming through with it this way rather than pushing down on it. And then this, it looks like a door, but actually this part in here is that's actually made to cut the tobacco off and give you like a full chamber. So I'll go ahead and I'll roll one here. And I know I always pile my tobacco here, and I use this old restaurant tray. It keeps all my mess right on here, because you're right, it is messy. So put that on there, throw my tube on. Of course, because of the way I like it packed and using the shorts, I always just take a pair of flush cut scissors on the end and I cut them off, and it makes a nice cigarette. And they always fill out nice. And then, of course, cutting them off, they kind of look like your bottom that way. So, what else? Oh, this Veracruz tube. You might have seen that. Kind of a unique looking tube. A little bit pricey compared with the other ones. But this is a king size. And these will definitely make your cigarettes smooth. Very, very good tube. No additives. It's a natural brown paper. Like them really well. I don't use them very often because they're the kings, but for a nice change. And the tobacco I buy it in a bulk. The smoke shop I have has tons and tons of them. They have their regular line, and then they have their premium line that have no additives at all. And so I buy two different kinds, two different flavors, and I mix them together and I get what I want. And I also use these water pillows. I don't know if that's got a price on it. It's $1.39 or whatever, and it lasts for about 3 months, and it keeps your tobacco moist. And you're supposed to be able to soak these in water again after they've dried out and use them again. I haven't tried that yet, but it says keeps your tobacco fresh for 60 to 90 days. So anyway, I hope that helps. If you have any other questions or anything, leave a comment and I'll see if I can answer it. If not, good luck with it. You can definitely save some money. I buy for what one carton of cigarettes cost, and I used to smoke about a carton a week. And I can buy enough supplies that will last me a whole month for what one cigarette carton cost. So, thanks for watching.